histogram is a type of graph, very similar to a bar chart, that easily shows us the shape of the distribution, such as the skewness or the bimodality. Histograms can show us if the data are bimodal, with two major peaks. We see skewness, such as a positive skew. Kurtosis, how peaked or flat the distribution is, which also shows the spread or variability in scores. And unusual, extreme scores or data entry errors called outliers. Histograms show us the shape of the distribution. When all of the scores are stacked on one end of the distribution, it is said to be skewed, and the histogram shows us the skewness. When the scores have two major peaks, they are bimodal, and the histogram shows us the bimodality. If we have outliers in the data, these will show up on the histogram, as will the shape of the kurtosis or the spread of the data. Unlike a bar chart, the adjacent bars in a histogram touch. This indicates that the data are connected to each other. We could not rearrange the numbers 1 through 5 to run 1, 4, 2, 5, 4. They must be in numerical order, and each bar is therefore connected to the next. Like the bar graph, the vertical bars are centered over the scores on the x-axis. The width of the bar corresponds to the real upper and lower limits of the interval. So for instance, a bar for the 4 actually includes scores from 3.5 to 4.49 because of rounding. The edges of the bar will actually be at those points. Now, histograms are used with interval and ratio level data, what we will call scale data in SPSS. They are particularly useful when the scale data are in ranges or banded, such as age 25 to 30, 31 to 45, 46 to 50, etc. If you have a scale, however, it is always a good idea to not band your data if you don't have to, because this causes a loss of information. A frequency polygon, also known as a line graph, is similar to a histogram, except that instead of bars, a data point is placed over each x-axis score, and then the dots are connected by a single line. Frequency polygons are used for large numbers of interval or ratio, i.e. scale level, scores. Typically, the x-axis begins one unit lower than the lowest appearing score, and frequencies are still plotted on the y-axis. As the frequency of scores goes up, you see increases in the line of the frequency polygon. Frequency polygons are often used to show change over time, such as in this example, gun murders in Canada between 1961 and 1991. If the area below the graph is filled in with color or shading, it is an area graph. So returning to our Clickers.sav dataset, we will use a histogram to show us the shape of the data and to identify potential outliers. This will help us identify what is wrong and if anything can be done to fix it. You may recall that when we created a bar chart with error bars for each of the three rounds of group interaction, we noticed that the error bar for the mean around round one was greater than for the other rounds. I suspect we may have some outliers that are causing that. Let's use a histogram to get a closer look at our data. In SPSS, we're using the Clickers.sav dataset. Let's go to Graphs and Chart Builder. The information from a previous analysis is still in, so we'll click Reset to clear that out. And now we're ready to move to the gallery. Now here in the gallery, we'll start by choosing Histogram. You'll notice there are four options, and we're going to be using the Simple Histogram. So drag Simple Histogram into the canvas. And if you want to see not the variable labels, but the variable names, you can right-click or Control-click on Mac to display variable names. For this example, we're going to drag the participation from round one into the x-axis, and the y-axis will change automatically. And by default, it will change to histogram. Now we can change that here in the Elements property window. From histogram, we could choose histogram percent. From here, let's make some other changes. Click on Set Parameters. Under Anchor First Bin, choose Custom Value for Anchor. We're going to set the value to 0. Under Bin Sizes, click Custom and set the interval width to 1. Click Continue and then Apply and then OK. There's our histogram. Something may be wrong. Let's take a closer look. Now check the histogram. See any obvious problems? Looking at the resulting histogram, we see that the scores are all collected on the left side of the graph. And there are these two unexpected bars on the right end. Now the x-axis goes to 60, but the options for the Likert scale only ran from 1 to 7. Something is clearly wrong. It looks like we have an outlier. In fact, we have two outliers. As the great philosopher Rick Perry once said, oops. This histogram does not look like what we expected to see. These values are supposed to be between 1 and 7. It looks like something really has gone wrong. And we're going to need to do something about that. And so, we're going to sniff out those outliers with a box plot.